Now, you've probably never seen a composition like this. CGCP 1635, Four Knights versus Two Rooks. This is actually a variation of the Four Knights versus Queen that we saw in CGCP 1606. That one contained 7 pieces, and even though it was an original composition by Chastetica, I wanted to demonstrate that Chastetica could compose beyond 7 pieces as well, a similar type of position, because the Lomonosov endgame table base for 7 pieces exists, and even though it contains more than 500 trillion positions, some people might think that the 1606 position was taken from that database somehow. So this composition of Four Knights versus Two Rooks, this is 8 pieces, such an endgame table base does not exist. So hopefully this removes any doubts anyone might have about the composition capabilities of Chastetica. Here the queen is replaced by two rooks. So you're looking at a mate in 5 here, and you're probably not going to find this particular type of composition, Four Knights versus Two Rooks, anywhere. So this may be the only one of its kind to date. This was also published in the Chessbase article related to the Four Knights versus Queen, the follow-up article to that, I believe. Anyway, the solution is as follows. So notice how there's only one way to win here. All the other moves lead to a draw. White plays king to c2. Now the threat here is knight on the first rank on the c-file to b3, checkmate. There are 3 knights on the c-file, so the one on the first rank. Therefore, if black were to play a rook to a7, the knight moves to b3, delivering checkmate. So what can black do? The best delay is rook to e2 check. Now it's important for white to proceed carefully here, capturing with the knight that we just talked about, the one on the first rank, extends the mate longer than it needs to be, as you can see from the analysis. White needs to capture with the middle one on the third rank, the other knight basically. And now here black could proceed with rook captures e2, and then the knight captures e2. Black has no other moves but to play king to a2. Black can play this move because the knight on c1 captured the rook. So white continues to set up the previous plan. The knight moves back to c1, the king moves back to a1, and then knight on the fifth rank of the c-file to b3 delivers mate. If we take a look here, black could also have proceeded by playing rook to b7. And here, it would be important for white not to capture this rook, because then black is stalemated. The rook on b7 prevents any knight moving to b3. But white does it anyway. And after rook captures b3, knight captures b3, king to a2, and then either knight to c1 mate or knight to c3 mate. Until next time, thanks for watching.